Hey, what's up, everybody? We are back today with a full stealth-based no-kills walkthrough for completing Mission 8, the Grand Palace. In this, we'll be hitting all the relevant side quests, as well as picking up the blueprints, bone charms, runes, and paintings that you'll find while on this mission. We will also be robbing the black market and dealing with all the howlers out there in a way a little bit different than the way we did with Emily, since we don't have Domino. So make sure you stick around and check that out. Hopefully, that'll help you through your Corvo attempt at a stealth-based playthrough. But that's it, so sit back, relax, and enjoy. Welcome to Mission 8, the Grand Palace. We dialed ourselves up an Uber while we were on the Dreadful Whale. Megan showed up in the skiff, and now she's dropped us off down here. From this point, head over here, and you're going to grab a raw whale bone. Around here, you're going to grab some angelfish scales. And then you're going to head up these stairs. Around the corner. Through here, sneak up here, grab this raw whalebone behind here, pickpocket that merchant, into the cash register we shall go, grab a few coins, close it, peek out, see where the guards are at. There are two guards right here. There's that guy that walks away, and then there's this guy that walks away. As soon as they walk away, head down through here, and ever so carefully make your way around here to the back, into this alley. And once you get into the alley, you can loot some feathers down here by this beggar.
You don't belong here.
And then go ahead and switch to blink and get up on here. Well, once you're up here, hit another blink and get up on here. From here, turn around, head in this window. This is the sculptor's studio. Come over and undo the vise. Grab a black bone charm. Grab a raw whalebone. Grab a scrimshaw. Grab two more scrimshaws. Sneak. Head out here.
No, you bastard.
And then hit a blink down here into the Winslow Safe Company.
There is no such permit, Captain. I know the laws in Karnaka.
And head right around here to the back. And grab this gate code off the desk. This is one of many ways in order to get back and rob the black market. You can choose whichever way you want. I'll show you a few in here. What you're waiting for is a conversation to stop going on upstairs, and the guard that's up there that is extorting the black market vendor to walk down these stairs and then walk out the front door. So if you just hang out right here, you can get a good perspective on him when he comes down the stairs, and that's all you're waiting on. There's a key in here that we want to grab out of the cash register, and if you wind up grabbing the key while the guard is in here, he alerts and comes downstairs, and that's something you generally want to avoid. He's walking down right now. There he goes. He's going outside. And once he's outside, you can just head back through here, get up on this, crack this open.
Sorry, but that's not an area for customers.
Grab that stuff, head out here, and then hit a blink up here on this corner. Once you get up here, back around the back here. I have no idea what that gate code was, so let's go ahead and take a look at it. We go over to mission clues. It looks like it was 435, so we'll dial that in. 435. Crack this open, and at this point, what I want you to do is save your game, because there is some funniness that goes on back here, and I want you to be able to avoid it just in case it happens to you. Now that you've saved your game, head up here. Go ahead and snatch the key from her. Grab this other way that you can get the back alley gate code. All right, so you can just pickpocket it from her if you chose to come to this area via another path. But then go ahead and choke her out. Pick her up. And we're just going to take her right up here. And drop her down. Just leave her right there, head down through here, around this way and grab some withered ryegrass. And then check and see who died. Alright, nobody's dead yet, so hopefully we're good. There is a howler that stands in the black market. He's the reason I had you save your game, because when that explosion goes off, occasionally it can kill him. I have no idea what causes it. I've been over here and had it go off. I've been upstairs and had it go off. I've been back here and had it go off. It's bullshit. I don't know what causes it, but it can kill him, so you have to watch out for that. So we'll see more about what the status of that guard is when we get back to the black market and decide to buy some things from there, and we can see what's really going on with him. But the reason you wanted to grab that key is because she is the captain of a smuggler's boat, and it is on that boat that you find the passcode to get into the black market through that back entrance. The reason he wouldn't let her in is because she forgot the passcode. So we're going to head out here, peek around and check where the guards are, and then just make our way right down here. There is a situation in which this can bug out back here, and the guards that are supposed to be robbing the ship and collecting everything from it aren't able to do that, and they wind up getting bugged back here. And they're standing right here. If that happens for you, you can do a drop takedown on the male guard. Just make sure you're sneaking, and then pick him up and bring and blink back up to the top with him. What happens is, you're not seeing it on the screen right now, but for some reason, when this boat loads into the game as this asset, it loads in beneath water level, and you wind up with a bunch of water right here. When that happens, that somehow causes the guards to bug, and there's a female guard here who's just walking face first into this door, at which point, once you get back up here with him, lay him down, you can come down here, grab her, choke her out, and then bring her up here. Why I'm telling you to bring them up here is if you lay them down here, they wind up drowning because of the little bit of water that is present in the boat. It's a bug. Maybe they'll fix it in the future, but it does occasionally happen, so I wanted to point it out. If you read this note, you find out that the Grand Guard has confiscated everything from the boat, and we're going to have to go track down the audiograph machine in another spot. So just keep all that in mind. 2 out of 10 times, the guards bug out back there, and I have to deal with that situation. It's not too big of a deal, but it is a big deal if you wind up drowning the guards when you choke them out. So I did want to mention that. All right, we're going to head back through here, keeping an eye on the guards at all times. And we're going to head right through here and blink back up on top of here. We're going to blink back up on top of these pipes as soon as we get the mana. And then right back through the sculptor's studio. We'll go out this entrance this time. We're going to get up on this railing and head over here. From here, we're going to head up on top of this. Just like that. And then we're going to get over to this balcony. Now, if you have not been robbing the black market in all of these missions, when you head down the alleyway that is right in front of this pillar, there are going to be two howlers blocking your path that you'll have to contend with. By coming up in this apartment here, you can grab this fan, you can grab this silver snuff box, but you can also come around here to the back and come out this window and bypass that alley entirely, drop down, and the black market is in this building right here. So if you haven't been robbing the black market, that's the path you want to take. Now, if you have been robbing the black market, things change a little bit because there are 5 howlers back there waiting to ambush you, not just 2 in this alley, and that's what's happened for us. So we have a little bit more work to do in order to get back there. But what we're going to do now is blink down here onto this ledge, and we're going to blink over here onto this pillar. And then we are going to blink over here to this balcony. It is in this apartment that you will find the 2 guards that stole everything from the ship. To peek around and realize that neither one of them is here. I'll take that.
This whole setup is a huge pain in the ass. Timing windows
Just watch out just in case they decide to show up. I don't know where they are. Usually there's a guard sitting here and then one futzing around in this corner walking back and forth, so you kind of have to watch out for them. But grab yourself these ivory scrimshaw. Head over here, make sure there's no more loot. Once again, we don't have dark vision, so my memory's failing me on exactly what's in here. Crack that stuff open, crack this open inside. You're going to find some sleep darts, incendiary bolts, howling bolts, and sticky grenades. Keep in mind that these sleep darts are here just in case you want to come back and grab them before you move on. Watch out for the giant spotlight. Then head out here, and we're just going to get up on here and turn this thing off. That's not turning it off. Set the whale oil tank down and then head up here. Sorry, head back down here. I wasn't expecting those guards not to be here. It's throwing me off. All right, now that you've made it here, what I want you to do is head downstairs one level.
Of course I can read.
Oh shit, here come the guards now.
I know all my letters and then some.
But let's go upstairs one level. Check him out. He should be walking into this apartment. Usually wait a while before I come get the audiograph, so I'm used to guards being in that room, but apparently if you hit it early enough, there's no guards, so that's a good tip. Not even I knew that. Alright, we're going to head up these stairs, and what we're going to do is use a crossbow bolt on this board right here. Make your way down to right about this third panel, turn around, and hit this second board. This is going to alert a nest keeper that is in this apartment, hopefully. It didn't. Okay, so now you need to deal with the fact that he hasn't been alerted. In order to do that, if you head upstairs, you're going to find a couple guards that you're going to have to contend with. So we're going to get up on this awning, get up around here, and we're going to blink down behind this one. Choke him out, pull him back.
Come on, come on.
Set him down here. And then we're just going to choke this guy out. Let him fall where he may. And then we're going to come over here and grab a bottle. So, you have to alert that stupid nest keeper in here. In order to do it, you kind of need to be able to throw some crap in here. If this doesn't work, I'll show you another way to do it. There are other bottles you can use. That just pissed off the blood flies. All right. There's two more bottles upstairs you can grab if you want to take a less aggressive approach to this. But once these guys calm down, you can shoot your pistol off in there, and that will alert the nest keeper. Back in the window you shall go. Alright, we're going to get up on here. And then we're just going to shoot this and back way off. Still no nest keeper. This one could be a little challenging. Alright, dip down through here. And there's another one right here that you want to shoot, and then back off. That got his attention. I hear him talking now. So just wait, shoot him with a sleep dart when you see him pop around, and he'll drop, and you'll be good. So you just have to play around with it a little bit. One method doesn't always work, as I'm sure you know from playing the game. Now drop down in here, back off, shoot this nest. Once that's out of the way, everything in here is pretty much cleaned up. If you want a little bit of food, because like us, you got attacked by blood flies. There's some food right here. There is a bit of money in this cabinet. And then if you head around here, towards the back, you're going to find an atomizer solution in case you need one. Inside here, though, most importantly, there's a rune. And then back here, there's a painting and a little bit of money. Watch out, there is a blood fly nest right up here at top. Pop in, shoot that out. You can get through here, grab your painting, spin around. In this cabinet, you'll find a silver bar and a pistol. All sorts of good stuff there. And you're just going to head right back outside here. If you want to refill on pistol ammo for some reason, you can come up here and remember up on this table, there was some pistol ammo that we did not pick up. Actually, we did. All right, so all of that's cleaned up. The next step is to rob the black market. In order to do that, it gets a little tricky. So we're going to head down here. Get down on this balcony. Then we're going to head over here. Get up on top of this pillar. We're going to blink down in here. Remember, you want to avoid guards. And once you're down here, you're going to blink your way up into this window. It's very important that you hit the blink right into this window. Once you do, you're going to get as close to him as you can to get the notification, then just grab him and drag him back. Pick him up and hold on to him. The reason you want to do that is I'm sure when you saw us blink up in here, there was a little lightning bolt action on the other side. That's because there's two howlers over there. If you're having trouble with that happening, you can always blink up to this balcony right here and avoid that. Just one of those things you have to watch out for. So we're just going to set his body down here. So there's one of them right there. Probably don't want to hang out in the open too much, but if you want to do a little looting, there is some looting you can do in here. Head back out through here, try not to get spotted. And then make your way down off this balcony. You can drop down here, drop down in here, and you can pick up one, two of those. That is a dead body, All right. Now, what you're going to do is get up on this balcony here. And verify we have no dead bodies on us. And we don't. Wait, don't we? Nope, we don't. All right. And you're going to take out two howlers that are up here. There's also a howler down here, right back in this corner, and there's one inside the black market. So what you're going to do is save our game, and then we are going to blink up on this balcony. And then ever so carefully, we are going to grab this guy and choke him out. Drop him. And then ever so carefully make our way over here, grab her and choke her out and drop her. And then we are going to grab one of these howler dust, come over here and hit a blink right to this corner. Once you get here, hang tight. If you peek, you can see there's that howler right there that we're going to take out. In order to do that, in my opinion, the best thing to do is to swing around behind this pillar. Swing right here. Throw the dust. Choke her out. And then just drop her. Check your stats one more time. No spots, no alerts. Everything is good. Go ahead and loot her if you want. She's got a key for a locked apartment in here that we're not going to be going into, but I did want to point it out just because. And then go ahead and blink back up here and grab one more bottle of howler dust. Drop down here. Up on here. Up in here. Now there is a howler that hangs out right in here. It's not going to let us peek to see him, but he is there. Now what I want you to do is throw the howler dust in here. It's gonna blind him. Pick him up, drag him out, choke him out, and right outside we go with him. We're just gonna bring him out here and take him right back up on top of the balcony here where everybody else is hanging out. Drop him down and drop in here. Now before we go any further, I want you to come through here, break out these boards, and head down in this area. There is a little bit of money. There is a piece of raw whalebone, and most importantly, there's a shrine down here with two runes.
You're back at the heart of your homeland. A bigger, better palace than the one you sailed away from so long ago. Feeling nostalgic? Will you ever be comfortable in Dunwall again? Assuming you make it back. You've seen the suffering here, the decay, but, dear Corvo, would you even have lifted a finger if the Duke hadn't put Emily in harm's way? Be honest now. In any case, I know what you're after. The heart you carry can only hold one spirit at a time. So, if you want to walk out with a piece of Delilah, you better be ready to leave something behind.
Alright, once you've gotten that, we're going to head inside and do some upgrades at the black market, and then we are going to rob the black market. So, right up in here.
All the shopkeepers don't stand a chance in the city. Oh, I'm sorry. Please, come
go to gear and do whatever upgrades you want. We are going to move over here and pick up some additional upgrades for our bullets. Just because we have a bunch of money. And we're going to go down here and hit this.
A deal well made.
And we're going to go through here and pick up extra spring razors because we don't need them. Pick up sticky grenades so the black market vendor sells them. Upgrade our spring razors because we don't need them, and that is going to be the extent of it. Now we're going to back out.
Perhaps I should close the shop until the dust settles.
And turn around here. So the other way you can go to rob the black market, to get behind it, is to come up here and go down this path. This is where we stuck that chick, remember? And then just head right down through here. So you can do either one, that'll get you over here, and being able to get the gate code from her when she's here, if you take that path, is what allows you to open the gate in the back with the code if you want to go out that direction for some way. So,
we'll
give him his
passcode.
Whatever. And then we'll just knock him out. Drop him down. And then we're going to come over here and make sure we pick up the disabled carriage rails item. This is going to disable the carriage rails in the area. That normally is something you can buy from his shop. But when that weird explosion happens that I showed you, for some reason or another, it blows it off the shelf and you can no longer purchase it. You've got to rob the black market in order to get it, which is, you know, kind of bullshit, but whatever. Such is the way of bugs. Now, right here for this coin, right here for this coin, and then we're going to come over here. Sleep darts, incendiary bolts, crossbow bolts, bullets, we definitely needed those. Spring razors, sticky grenades, stun mines, atomizer, health, and a rewire tool. So that's the extent that's in here. Now, we're going to head out. We're going to head down over here. Crouch, and we're going to go right back up into the sculptor's studio. If we can. There we go. Then we're going to go right back out the back window. Down here again. Drop down, drop down. And then what you want to do is get up on the carriage rails if you can manage it. Alright, once you get up on the carriage rails, make your way down, and you're really interested in this guard that is right here in front of this grandfather clock.
You just can do a drop takedown on her. That will take her out. The problem is you have to watch out for this guard and where he is when you're going to do that. So he comes and stands right about here, and eventually he will turn around and walk away, at which point we will deal with her. Gonna grab her, drag her back, grab her gun in case you need it, head inside, close the doors, and take her up with you to the third floor. If you want to do some looting, you can go in this door here. Just know there's a civilian and a couple guards in there you have to contend with. We're not going to deal with them because, in my opinion, there's really no point. But you're going to head up these stairs to the third floor, crack this door open, and just set her in the corner here. Right, if you need some food, there's food in here. Close the door. Around here, there's a bit of money. Swing around to the right here, up over the bed. You're gonna find a fan on that cabinet. And then back here, you're gonna find a bone charm, very important, and some bath salts. Now that you have all of that, we are going to go out onto this balcony. And then we're going to hit a blink. Try to hit a blink onto the tracks. Blink works a lot easier getting to the tracks than Far Reach does as Emily. If you're having problems, you can always blink over here and then go up to the tracks just by a quick jump, right? Either one will work. With Emily, it's a little harder to Far Reach down here for whatever reason. You usually wind up Far Reaching through the tracks. All right, now you need to watch out for this guard right here and this guard right here. Let's keep an eye on both of them. Wait for him to walk back and get to about here, and then make his way back across. That's what you're really waiting for. You want to catch him on his walk away, not when he's meandering back here and you're hoping he's not going to walk away as you try to blink in this building. Eventually, this guard will walk away. You still have this guard down here to contend with, but once he decides to go his own way, you're just going to Far Reach as far as you can go, and then right in this door, close the door behind you, and you're good to go. Now from here, you're going to go in the shopkeeper's apartment. This is the apartment that key you grabbed from the Winslow Safe Company unlocks. It's not the only way to get in this apartment. You can possess a rat right there and go through this rat tunnel if you'd like. We have possession, so we could have totally done that. You could use rat shadows to do that if you have... Shadow Walk, Rat Shadows, a new game plus, or if you're playing as Emily. But head in here, grab this stuff, go ahead and grab this blueprint, and then turn around, grab that cigar box, chop this out of the way, grab that bone charm, and then check out this code that says 123, and punch that in on this safe. 1, 2, and 3. Inside, you're going to find some pistol ammo, a little bit of money, and that's about it. If you want to smash this open, because no one will hear you, you can grab a little more bath salt action, but eventually be done in here and hit these to go to the Grand Palace. All right, from here... Take note, there are some guards right here. They do eventually stop talking, get up, and walk away. But before they do that, if you want, you can just blink your way down to these stairs. Get around the back, get up on here, and make your way up to the disabled carriage rail tracks. Remember, you can step on them now because they've been disabled, and make your way through here. If you want to swim across, you can take these stairs down to this next level, and beneath us you will find two veteran guards. See if I can get your perspective on them. So there they are right there. They both have their backs turned like that, so it's pretty easy to take them out. You just hit a stop time and then do a drop takedown on one of them, and then you can choke the other one out. It makes for pretty easy going. But eventually, you make your way over here and find yourself at the Grand Palace. When you do get to this point, I highly suggest you save your game. Alright, now that you've saved your game, what you're going to do is head around here, get up on this light post. Come on, let us up there. There we go. From here, you're going to get over on this light.
The palace.
Maybe and I then you're going to get on this light. Once our mana comes back. And then you're going to get up on the roof. Head over here, look down. Occasionally there's a guard down here. Otherwise, there's this civilian. And if you just head over here, you can do a quick drop takedown on her, knock her out, crouch, pick her up, and we're going to go right back up top with her. And then right back up on this roof. Nobody finds bodies up on this roof, so this is a place I like to stash them. Alright, just go ahead and stash your body right there. No problems. We'll jump down here. First thing to check. Oh, look at that! Somebody. Oh, hey. Somebody's in the throne room, and the person in the throne room is smoking a cigar. That means it's the body double. Sweet. Hey, we really lucked out on this one. This isn't like the Emily playthrough where we got him in the damn private garden. That would have sucked. Alright, hang out in here, watch what goes on. Eventually the body double finishes doing what he's doing. He gets up and then winds up dismissing these two guards. So that's what you really want to wait on. We're just going to move to this chandelier and hang out and just wait for it to happen. Don't go to this chandelier because there's a pylon in here that will shock you to death if you do it. So just wait this out. I know it sucks, especially if you're impatient, but just wait it out. He'll get up. And then he'll say something like, I want to be alone. Come on, Dookie.
Sometimes a man just needs time by himself. Responsibilities weigh upon me.
Once he does that, both of the guards will then walk out the door there. The other one walks from the other side of the room, right underneath the chandelier, and right out the door. So she's kind of slow, so you gotta wait on her. And there she goes. Once that happens, you need to hit a blink all the way to this back corner as far as you can go. Once you get back here, take the whale oil tank out, set it down, and then come over here, talk to the Duke. This is actually the body double, sorry.
No offer to bow or kiss my hand.
I'm not that kind of visitor.
A mystery. Let's have it then. Who are you and what do you want?
All right, and if you can't find out whether it's the body double or the Duke because you don't notice them smoking, you can always point your heart at them. And based on what your heart tells you, you'll know whether it's the Duke or the body double. So I think you're the Duke's body double is what we're going to say.
You're the Duke's double, aren't you? I'm here to take him down, but I might need your help. Do you want to listen to what I have to say?
All right, you've figured it out. But if you're not here to assassinate the Duke, what do you want?
I have no doubt that you'd be a more agreeable Duke than Luca Abel. If I wanted to depose him without having to cut out his heart, could you convince people that you are the Duke?
That's bold. I have to admit it's crossed my mind. If people believed that I was actually Duke Abel and that he was the political decoy, we could have him committed for lunacy. We could convince everyone that the double's finally lost his mind and believes he's the Duke. I've spent years perfecting my performance, but there's a catch. He's got a medallion that I need. Even if I sound convincing, which should be the easy part, his Grand Guard officers will ask to see the medallion as proof. Luca never puts it aside.
All right. It shouldn't take me long. Once it's done, I'll be leaving the city. Soon after, I'll send instructions from Dunwall and I'll expect a great deal of flexibility and cooperation on your part. There's still time to pull Sir Konos back from the edge of the cliff. We can undo the damage Duke Bell has inflicted.
I'd like that. But I'll guide Sir Konos in the ways I see fit for the people here, not as the hand-chosen puppet of your empire. If you agree with that, just render the Duke unconscious and bring him to his chambers. I'll handle the rest.
Okay, go back to sneaking, come over here, grab some coins, grab this bone charm, grab this pistol, and then head right back out the way you came. And from this point, I want you to save your game. Alright, now that you saved your game, if you're really impatient, you can just sleep dart both of these people from this position. That's not what we're going to do. We're going to get up on here, make our way down to the edge, and get a better position to take them out. If you listen to their conversation a little bit, it will play out, and then they will change their positions. That's what I like to do, because it keeps them from seeing each other fall.
The inner circle is packed with the Duke's S.
Just gonna put stop time on here.
Exactly. And think, when all this fighting over thrones is settled, the Duke's going to need men to take charge of the Northern Isles. By this time next year, you could be in charge of Whipdown or Freyport.
Where even the most desirable have skin like pale slugs.
That's what the brand is for. Okay, now she's going to come over here. He's going to turn to the left. I want you to hit your stop time. Go here for a sleep dart. And zoom in. Zoom in. Shoot her. Shoot him. And watch him fall. And they're both down. So, now, we're going to put Blink on, and his Blink over here, grab his body, and we're going to go right up here with it, and then we're going to go right up here with it, soon as we get our mana back. Come on, give me the marker. All right, and we're going to stash the body right here. And then we're going to drop back down. Back down here, grab one more body. We're going to go up here. Back up here and drop that one. So now they're both out of the way. Nobody sees them. It's all good. Now, right down here. I'm going to go right down in here. And I want you to get in this window. From this window, this is where it gets interesting. So you're going to hit a blink over to this couch as close as you can get it.
Are you all right?
More bad things have happened here in the last 5 years.
Then you're going to blink down here, kind of to the right. This guy's unconscious, so you don't have to worry about him. What you do have to worry about is three girls in this room. So what you're going to do is just head in here, hit a stop time, run inside, grab this bone charm, and then right back outside. Up here to this couch, hang out, and you're going to hit a blink back in this room, up onto this couch. Oh, crap, you can't hit it. You want to go up onto the bookcase here. and then out. You just have to be careful about the civilians that are out on this balcony, them seeing you do that. Normally, I don't pause there while stop time is ending. I usually will run into this room and blink up here to this window, but I was trying to explain, so that's why there was the weird delay. But that's how I would generally do that. Now, from here, we're going to go up onto the roof. From here, we're going to get up on top of here. And then we're going to get up where these smokestacks are. We're just going to go right down here. And at this point, I would suggest that you save your game. Alright, now that you've saved your game, what I want you to do is drop down one level, carefully drop down one more, and then hit a blink to the front of this little box, and then hit a blink over here. Alright, drop down through here, peek through this keyhole, see what's going on, see where the maid's at, see where the guard's at. The maid is in the corner, the guard is right there. Just head inside, get up on top of this chandelier, get down here onto this bookcase, wait for the maid to walk away, and when she does, you're going to drop down and take this guard out. So just wait for her to turn and walk over here, and then it's safe to grab him. And she's going to go here, she's going to turn, she's going to walk away at that point, just drop down, choke him out, grab him, we're right back up top with him. You're going to lay him down, you're going to go right over here, you're going to grab her, choke her out, and you're going to put her right up here. Right, just place her right up. Same place you did the other one. Now you're going to drop down. Get some Atomire solution if you need it. Grab a dried bloodfly husk and your painting. Once you have that, head around here to the right and get this masterwork blueprint for upgrading your sword. And then head up here. You're going to find some money on the Duke's desk. Nothing wrong with free money. Head over here, and you're going to find the safe code to the first captain's safe. The first captain's safe is located just outside the throne room down on the first floor, so make sure you grab that. Now, we're going to head out of here, close these doors, head around through here, peek, make sure there are no guards walking around out here, make sure you're clear. If you are, crack the doors, close the doors, head around here, and check on the position of this maid. As soon as she turns the corner here, she's going to turn around and walk back towards that door. When she does, you're just going to pop inside, get up on this light, get over here on this light. And hang out. Now, the easiest thing to do with her is to just to sleep dart her. Occasionally, you can have problems in here because there's a guard that stands right here. And he can occasionally see you if you drop and take her down. But we're going to give that a shot anyways. As she walks around through here, she makes that turn. And then you can just drop behind her and choke her out. Just don't run into her as you drop behind her. All right. Grab her, set her over here. Once again, if you're having problems with that guard seeing you, just sleep dart her when she's away from the guard's field of vision and you don't have to worry about it. Then come in here and check the position of the guard in here. Oh, Jesus, he's standing right there. Okay. We're going to back off and let him move. You can also just sleep dart him if you want. It's not that big of a deal, but I do want to show you how you take them out if you don't have sleep darts left or something along those lines. Come on, son. Walk away.
Once they say something's amiss, then I just can't get comfortable.
Eventually he'll turn and walk away here.
It's not my job to clean up. I wonder if the rumors are true about the Crown Killer. The Royal Protector, really? What a bunch of degenerates.
You can just get in here, take him out, drag him back. Best thing to do with him is to bring him back here. Bring him back here and set him in this room. Right. You can also do that with the maid.
You've made your bed and have to lie in it. I don't make my bed ever.
Right back here and throw her in the closet as well. Alright. She's got her foot in the toilet. There's nothing wrong with that. She'll be fine. She'll have a wet foot when she wakes up. She won't know what happened.
Could be some sort of madman or cutthroat or pickpocket.
Grab a little coin and then head around here and figure out where this maid is. She will eventually stop doing whatever she's doing over here in this corner and walk around in this area, and you'll be able to get in here and take her out. You just kind of have to wait for it. Right now, my guess is she's over there sweeping. Eventually, she'll stop, walk over here. You can hear her walking right now. And when she does, you just want to get in here, grab her up, choke her out, and you're good to go. So, now, head over here, and you're going to grab some raw whalebone. You're going to head back here, get in this cabinet, grab a bone charm, close it up, and then get out of here. Let's see, is there anything in here? I don't think so. Alright. Nothing good on the desk. This is some lucky sapphire, or however you pronounce that. Adamire solution if you need it. Oh, we don't. So then we're just going to head out of here with her. Now, you can just dump her on the in the bathroom with the rest of them. So that's what we're going to do. Close the door behind you, and then their bodies have been hidden. And you don't have to worry about any of that. So they're all good. They're going to have a good time. Close this door. So we picked up our painting, we got our bone charm out of there, we got our painting out of here. Now we're going to head up to the fourth floor and deal with the Duke. Alright, so from here, we're just going to blink over to this little box. And from this box, we're just going to jump up on this one, and then blink up in here. And we got a bit of waiting to do, because there is a guard standing right here. You can see his feet right there. The Duke will eventually dismiss him, and that's what we're waiting for. So we're just going to blink in here and wait till we hear him say, "Sometimes a man just needs time by himself."
Never-ending paperwork. What's the point of being my father's son if I have to slave away like this?
You could be reading the letter right now. Thinking about me. Right now.
Where is the galaxy? Where is it? Rah.
Come on, Duke. Say those magic words. I want to be alone with my thoughts. When he says that, you're going to head over here, close these doors. Close them. Grab a few bath salts. And then hide in the corner. The reason you're hiding in the corner is that guard that was up there with him is now going to walk all the way down here through this room. And out the double doors that are on the other side of these ones that we just closed. As soon as he's gone, it's safe to go up and take out the Duke. But you do have to wait for him. And he is one slow-ass mofo. He does not move quickly down here. He's getting paid by the hour. He doesn't give a shit. That's my guess. But just keep an eye right here. And you'll see him pass in front of you. Once you do, you know you're good. I can hear him walking. So he'll go right through there. And just drop through here and peek out the keyhole, make sure he's gone.
Get on out of here.
Okay, now that he's gone, crack the doors. close the doors, whip out a sleep dart. That's what I like to use on the Duke. It's just so much easier than wasting mana on a stop time or anything like that. You just gotta head up here and make sure that you know where the Duke is. So watch for his little icon. Sometimes he goes over here and sits, and that's the best way to take him out. You can also get up on the railing over here and get a perspective on him. And he goes down. So much for instant sleep darts. All right, loot him. That's going to get you the vault key. Pick him up. Come over here, unlatch this door. And then come around in this direction, and I want you to pick up this egg. I want you to pick up these coins. He was too heavy. I set him down. And you're going to grab a piece of raw whalebone, and if you need some health, go ahead and grab that. Otherwise, grab his body. And then right around here, down these stairs, over to the bed, and watch a little cutscene.
That's it then. Now it's up to me. I'll take the medallion and call him.
I'll be watching. Break a leg.
Don't worry. I've spent years mimicking this asshole. Captain Almeida, come at once to my chambers. There's a problem.
Tony Almeida, hide up there. Come quickly to my chambers.
This clown. Seems that he took his role a little too seriously. Get your hands off me. He served me well for years. We'll never find anyone else who so bears my resemblance. Take him away, Captain. But be gentle.
I think I understand, Your Eminence. We'll handle it.
What? This is outrageous. I'll have you all skinned alive and set in a salt bath. If only there was something we could do for him. I suppose all those years pretending he was me, that eventually took its toll. No! Stop! I am the Duke of Sacronis! You can't do this!
Dr. Hypatia and Atomire will know what to do with the poor man.
Alright, eventually she's going to walk away. Then the cutscene will end. You will sneak again and head right out here through this door, close that door, and then you're going to head right down here. Put a blink on and get down to this ledge. There's a guard here that is eventually going to peek his face across this ledge, and you're just kind of waiting for that so you can take him out. He hangs out on this balcony. But if you screw around too much out here, he will spot you. I hear him walking now. There he is. I just want to wait for him to walk away. When he does, hope over the ledge, grab him up, choke him out, pick him up, and we're just going to take him right back upstairs. I don't know that this is necessary, but I do like to do it. And then right back up here. He's got a little more perspective on us than I really like when we're trying to make our way down to the vault. So that's why I like to use that approach with him. Then you're just going to drop down here onto this ledge again. And then what you're going to try to do is make a blink down onto this platform. Okay, you may have to extend it a little bit like this, and you may take some damage, but it'll get you there.
They can rob my boy for all I care. I've got enough to worry about without their constant complaining.
When I blink onto the dome, I tend to fall off, and it's just, it never goes well. So, up onto this light fixture, over onto this light fixture, and then down here onto this pillar, if you can make it. Just like that. And then over here on top of this roof. And then right down here into the corner. You gotta go right into the corner. Alright. Grab this whale oil tank, take it out, and just set it down. And then use the Duke's key to open up his vault. Careful, there's a clockwork soldier that patrols down here, so you gotta watch out for that. As soon as the vault opens, I just like to close it and back into the vault. Now, if you head downstairs, you are going to find that there is a clockwork soldier down here that you need to contend with. The best way to do that, in my opinion, is to take him out with a crossbow bolt once you see him. A real easy way to do it is to simply use stop time and then run in there and shoot him in the head the first opportunity you get. That's what we're going to wind up doing as soon as he comes around this corner here. It's just safer. If you have dark vision in here, it makes things go a lot smoother, but since we don't have it. It's easier just to come over here, put on this, shoot his head out, then run, crouch, and wait for his head to go boom.
Triggering electrostatic discharge. Stand clear.
All right, that should have taken his head off. If we go in here and look.
This is the thing Ashworth made to hold Delilah's spirit.
His head's gone, which is good. So now that his head's gone, you can do a little bit of looting. We'll refill on that atomizer that we used to do stop time. So that's why it's pretty much safe to do it here, because you get a refill anyways. If you need a rewire tool because you chose to rewire the clockwork soldier instead, you can get your refill there. There's some withered ryegrass here, and if you swing around to the back, you're going to find your collectible souvenir for this mission.
Keep this old
a piece thing. Of raw whalebone, and then head over here and interact with Delilah's spirit. Generally, once you do this, that clockwork soldier explodes.
You must release me from this dead vessel. Only then you'll be able to trap Delilah's spirit.
Jessamine, your spirit comforts me. How can I let you go?
I've given you all I can, my love. Tried to guide you. Now our daughter will need you.
Be at peace, my dear Empress. Star of my sky.
Your eyes, your hands, your heart. With my last thought,
that it's done. Now it's time to return to Miles.
Only her flesh remains.
Maybe Delilah's spirit was holding it together.
You gotta watch out, because even though you take him out in here at a certain spot, he's not always in that certain spot. So we're gonna pick up a bone charm, a rune, and then one more rune, and then we will be out of here. So through here, I'm gonna hit this button. Start sneaking. Over here on this table, we're going to pick up another blueprint. Go ahead and grab that. Then we're going to go down here and grab this black bone charm. Smash this screen out. And before you go any further, I would highly suggest you save your game, because you can drown trying to do this. Alright, now that we've saved our game, we're going to go for a bit of a swim here. Try to keep yourself above water as long as you can. And then right here, you're going to dip down through here, underneath here, and around to the back. Up on here, you're going to find your rune. Go ahead and grab that. Now we're going to head up these stairs. All right, once you get up here, I want you to spin around, and there is a piece of raw whalebone in here you can grab. Go ahead and grab that. Back up and get some air. And then down underneath here, up these stairs. Once you get up here, I want you to hang tight, because you're going to deal with some of these bloodfly nests. The best way to deal with them, in my opinion, is just use your combustion bolts. But if you don't want to do that, you can always use bullets. Of course, that's not a bullet. You can throw your heart at it, and it works perfectly fine. Oh, I love the upgraded pistol so much. So much. Alright, turn the corner here. Get in the back. Get around here. Check out where the next one is and take it out. Oh, that's so much fun. Don't have to worry about getting close to them anymore to take them out. Now, there's two ways to get out of here. You can go through these boards, or you can go through these boards down here. Either one winds up taking you up to the top level, but before you do either, just depending on who may be hanging out around here, you'll want to watch out and take a quick look and a listen to see if there are civilians in whatever path you try to take. So that one, there are some civilians out there. Down here. See if there are any civilians out here. It doesn't look like it, so we'll chance this one. We'll break these boards out. Nobody freaks out. That means no civilians nearby. Now what we're going to do is go back up top here and go into the first captain's safe. In order to get up here, hit a blink right here. All right, and then hit a blink right here. Don't jump, hit a blink, okay? Once you have the blink, you're gonna blink up here. If you can manage it. Come on, give me the blink up there. All right, then you're gonna blink up here. Of course, it's not gonna let us, which is ridiculous. Why would not let me blink on top of this structure? There we go. So stupid. Blink is not my favorite, as you can have probably been able to ascertain through the walkthrough. I like Far Reach so much better. The only downside of Far Reach is when you try to blink onto carriage rails. That's the only downside, in my opinion. All right, right down through here, through these doors. There's a sleeping civilian in here. She doesn't wake up, so you don't have to worry about her. Just gonna head right through here, crack these doors open, and then you need to contend with the first guard captain that's in here. If you just get up on this light fixture, you can head to the edge, get up on this light fixture. Well, wait for your mana to come back. Then you can get up here.
Just by looking at his shoes.
And you can just drop down behind him. Choke him out. And then you don't have to worry about him anymore. Well, once you have done that, though, come around here, grab this stun mine if you're not full, then head back to the safe, go into your mission clues, and you'll see that the code is 898. We'll dial that in. 8, 9, and 8. And inside we will find our final rune. Grab that. Now, as you leave this area, feel free to take him with you and put him up on the roof. If that's how you want to roll out of here, totally acceptable solution. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to leave his body. I don't care if his body gets spotted. It doesn't really matter. Grenades if you need them. Sleep darts if you need them. Crossbow bolts if you need them. Health if you need it. Atomire if you need it. some more guns, all kinds of good stuff in here. There are two sleeping guards in here, so watch out for them, or one's sleeping and one's drunk and passed out. But now we're just going to head right out of here. Right up here. And we're going to get back up on the roof and make our way over to the docks. So we're going to get up here. And then we're going to go over here. Just like this. So remember, this is that guard we brought up from the Duke's balcony. So you can see we're right back on that side again. Big circle in here. Everything's connected. It's the circle of life. And then right down here. And I'll show you what happens. Well, actually, I don't want to do that because I don't want to screw it up at the end. Regardless, I hate the dome. The dome and I are not friends. All right, over here. Take some more damage. Hit this light. Hit this light. Come right here. Wait for the clockwork soldier to go away. And then make your way down here. Alright, make sure you hit this little quest objective, otherwise Megan doesn't show up. And then you can just get out here, blink over to these rocks, and make your way right down here, and this is where Megan will meet you. Oh, there she comes. With her crazy eyes and all.
I saw the signal.
Did you?
So, is that it? The fall of Karnaca?
The Duke's had a change of heart. Things are shifting.
Back to the dreadful whale, then, and on toward Dunwall.
It looks that way. To find a way to help Emily. And to give her back the throne.
Ready then?
Come on, let's leave this place.
All right.
Let's blow this popsicle stand. All right, you can see we're good. No bodies detected. We still have Ghostly. We're on our way to Clean Hands and Shadow. One mission to go. Over here, we did pick up all the collectibles. And we did a few extra things while we were in here. Let's go ahead and continue. Check out the cutscene that leads us to the next video that will go up on the channel.
This is how the worst day of my life began. A masked man closing in on Dunwall Tower. Now it's happening again. Another Empress falls, another story ends. Last time it almost ruined the Empire. Will I do any better? Delilah outfoxed me and I never saw it coming. But I was Corvo before I was the Royal Protector. Before I owned a sword, I fought with sticks and broken glass, whatever came to hand. I don't know what grand scheme you've got underway, Delilah, but I'll give all I've got to stop you.
And over here on the desk is the final souvenir that you're actually going to get to see when you pick the one up in Mission 9. You never actually get to see it on the Dreadful Whale. But that wraps everything up for Mission 8 as Corvo. If you've got any questions, please post them in the comment section below. I do know that there are various situations in the Grand Palace where the Duke shows up one place, the body double shows up in another, and it changes your approach to taking them out. If you check the video description, there's a link down there to the video walkthrough I did as Emily. In that video's video description and a pinned comment, there is a large wall of text, in which I describe how you would go about taking out the Duke or his body double based on where you find them. I'm not going to repeat it in this video, just for the sake of, I don't want to copy and paste all that crap around, but definitely take a look at it and use it at your own discretion, but it'll give you some additional tactics to use when you're in the Grand Palace, just in case the body double isn't in the throne room and the Duke isn't up in his chambers. So that's it, and as always, thanks for watching, guys. Take care.